Hey everyone, it's Chad.
And Clara.
And today, we're going to talk about maintaining component libraries and enabling contributions from consuming design teams. As a maintainer, some of the most common reasons why you update your libraries are to add features or properties to a component for parity with the code side, adding support for new Figma features like interactive components or auto layout, or fixing little bugs that may have been introduced into your assets. When you have a published library that your teams rely on for their daily work, if you're working on these kind of updates to your library and teams are coming into the file for information, there's a risk that work in progress component enhancements may be copied out and used in designs when they're not quite ready for production use yet.
On the contribution side, if you solicit contributions to your libraries in your organization today, your workflow may involve the contributor detaching a component to make updates, sharing that file with you as the maintainer, and some manual copying and pasting back into the component library before publishing. If work has also been happening on those same components in the library, the contributor could be working with an outdated asset, which can lead to even more work for the maintainer when accepting the contribution.
Let's take a look at how we can make both of these common component library workflows much more seamless by using branching. In our organization here, I'm one of the designers maintaining our design system assets, and Clara is a designer on the product side.
I'm starting my work for the day and open up my file. As I'm making edits, I notice the buttons aren't scaling correctly. Though I'd normally ping the design system team over chat, I know we have contribution guidelines in place, so I'll start there. I'm going to head back to the library file and propose an update by creating a branch. Though I'm a viewer on the library file, I can still create a branch. Since this is a bug fix, I'm going to include the correct prefix in the branch name to indicate what type of work I'm doing. Once the branch is created, I'm going to fill out the contribution template the design system team created. In the contribution type area, I'm going to select bug fix. Since I'm not contributing a new component, I'm going to mark everything else as not applicable. Let's go ahead and fix the alignment on the button.
Meanwhile, as Clara is working on a contribution in a branch, I'm going to start some enhancement work on our components. Talking with our design and development teams, we've agreed to add a new button variant to the system and change the name of the destructive button to danger to align with changes coming to the code side. I'm going to create a branch for these enhancements, so I'm not disturbing the current source of truth. All right, so let's take our buttons and we're just going to bring those in here and we'll set that up. All right, and while we're in here, let's also change the name of the destructive button to danger. All right, now that I've made these updates and the changes are going to be going live on the code side, I'm going to merge my branch into main. And since I'm an editor on the library file, I can go ahead and merge this without needing to request a review.
Now that I'm up to date and have my proposal, I'm going to request a review on my branch. In the description, I'm going to write a brief description of the issue and what I changed. The modal is already suggesting reviewers based on the editors of the main library file. I'm tagging in some members of the design system team, Chad and Tom.
Now, during our weekly design system meeting, we go through all of the branches in our library files to check for any that may be tagged as in review. In addition to a tag on the branch name, when a review is requested, the reviewers who have been tagged will get an email and a notification inside of Figma. If a notification comes in with a high priority prefix like bug fix, hot fix, etc., we'll typically prioritize those and take a look when they come in rather than waiting, since they may have a large impact to other users as well. Here I see that Clara found a bug with the buttons, so I'm going to open her branch and take a look. Here I can see that she's already made the fix in her branch, so I'm going to review this. And everything looks good here, so since I am an editor on the main file, I'm going to merge this and then I'll publish a new version of the library.
I now see that there's a library update, and when I accept the update, the button is fixed. And I got a shout out in the release notes. Having these contribution guidelines in place can help reduce back and forth between teams while tracking any updates made to the system. Even though this was for a smaller fix, this workflow can be used for any proposals you'd like to make to a library file.
We hope this can help you maintain and evolve your library assets and further solicit contribution to your design system libraries in a collaborative and structured way. Also, be sure to check out the design system contribution template in the Figma community, linked in the description below.
See you next time.